the beginning, I was at school in Dame Alice, and then I went to work at Shortstown at the Air Ministry, and then in 1943 I was in Eastney for 6 months, during which time I worked on coordinating the firing of guns, sat on a moving platform, and then I remustered and I did a 6 months training through HMS Excellent at the dockyard to be a stoker or a mechanic, a boat's crew mechanic. Portsmouth was terribly badly damaged. When I arrived in 1943, all of the damage had been done. It was all ruins. During the time, which was 2.5 years, that I was in the Wrens, apart from the beginning when I was on the floating platform, I was a boat's crew Wren, either on the Hamble River at Burselden, or later on, just before D-Day, I went further down the Hamble River to Wasash.
What did your parents do?
My mother was dead. My mother died when I was nearly eight. When my sister was born, 3 weeks afterwards, my mother died. Apparently, it was put down to flu, influenza. And father was an engineer, and thanks to the war, he got a job. He was unemployed in the 1930s, but by the time I went to the modern school, which would have been 1935, he'd got another job at Allen's Engineering.
Did he continue with that job during the war?
Yes, he always worked nights during the war.
So what did Allen Engineering do?
He was a sheet metal worker. The family were blacksmiths in the background, and so he really was doing a similar job. He'd worked at Howard's Engineering that made ploughs and things like that, and they were the ones that went bankrupt in the 1930s.
So presumably he was helping with the war effort?
Yes.
Do you know what the engineering company supplied?
They did the pumps. I don't know what they were for, presumably ships, but nowadays there are Quinn pumps, which you can hear about in the drainage things. But I don't know what their stuff was for.
Part of your life during the war, you were at school.
Yes.
Do you have any remembrances about anything that happened at school or how the war affected your education?
Oh, it's made us share with Woodford County High School, who came to Bedford. I think they had the afternoons and we had the mornings in school, and then the other part was for sport, but they always beat us at netball.
Whilst you were at school at Bedford, was Bedford bombed at all?
It was bombed the night when Coventry was bombed. I think that was the only time. It was on the way back, they were dropping landmines, but there were only one or two, so not the real damage.
So there were no specific targets in Bedford, it
no.
was just general bombing as the bombers went back to Germany.
Yes. They tried for the railway station. Place my father worked was next to the railway station, but that's the only connection.
Did you enjoy your time as a Wren?
Yes, I had a wonderful time.
Did you enjoy yourself at school?
Yes, I think I did. I was very ambitious. I always wanted to do well. I think that was my father's influence.
I'm just thinking back to your childhood, Kay. Your mum died
yes.
when you were very, very young, really.
Yes.
So was your dad looking after the two of you on his own?
Or did no.
You?
My sister was, I suppose you'd say farmed out. My sister went to live with my mother's brother and his wife. They already had teenage children, but they took this new baby and she became their family. But my father never allowed her to be adopted. We went to visit her once a month on Sundays, and he was her Sunday daddy, and I'm still her big sister.
Oh, that's lovely. So there was just you and your dad, was there?
At the time that my mother died, they had a lodger, a cousin of mine, and she was working for a local chemist as an assistant in the photographic thing. So she did all the developing and everything in there. And she would have been, I suppose, only about 19 or 20, but she helped look after me until she got married, and I was 15 by then.
Mm. You're so old enough to look after yourself,
yes.
really.
Yes, but
then.
My father was a wonderful. He's...
And just thinking as well about when you were at school and then you went into the Wrens afterwards, if it hadn't have been for the war, do you think you would have had that opportunity to do that kind of work?
No. I met a cousin of mine when I was about 14, and he was a radio operator on cruise ships. And I had always wanted to travel, but this was it. I wanted to join the Navy. But my father pointed out that the Navy wasn't for girls. And then about the following year, they resurrected the Wrens. And so all I'd got to do was to get my school certificate, because they allowed people who had naval connections into the Wrens, or people who had been reasonably educated, to tackle other jobs.